हेलो फ्रेंड्स, केजी क्लासेस में आपका स्वागत है। आज हम आपको ब्रीफ सर्वे ऑफ इंग्लिश पोइट्री। इंग्लिश पोइट्री बिगिन विद चौसर, ही इज कॉल्ड फादर ऑफ इंग्लिश पोइट्री। चौसर स्टैंड इन मच द सेम रिलेशन टू द लाइफ ऑफ हिज लाइन एज पॉप डज टू द 18th सेंचुरी एंड टेनिसन टू द विक्टोरियन एज। हिज प्रोलॉग टू द कैंटरबरी टेल्स इज ए पिक्चर गैलरी ऑफ 14th सेंचुरी इंग्लैंड। चौसर इज आल्सो कॉल्ड द मॉर्निंग स्टार ऑफ द रेनेसेंस जस्ट एज बाइक्लेफ इज कॉल्ड द मॉर्निंग स्टार रिफॉर्मेशन। बिफोर चौसर इंग्लैंड हैड एंग्लो सैक्सन पोइट्री। द ग्रेटेस्ट वर्क इन एंग्लो सैक्सन पोइट्री वाज बियोवुल्फ विच वाज ए कलेक्शन ऑफ बैलाड्स। After Chaucer, there was a decline in the poetry of England. The poet who appeared on the literary scene where his imitation followed, they were called Chaucerian. Occleve, Leggett and Skelton were only English poets. Writing poetry in imitation of Chaucer, James Hennison, William Dunbar, Gavin Douglas are the best known Scottish Chaucerian. In the 15th century, the poetry was not rich in quality, but it was rich in ballads. The 16th century was very rich in literary education. The Renaissance movement enriched English poetry as well as English drama. To the Hells, Miss Selenary was published in 1557. It was a collection of songs and sonnets. Betts and Surrey were the great poet of this period. Sir Philip Sidney, another remarkable poet this age, produced outstanding poetry of love. This age is particularly known as the age of sonnet. William Shakespeare, a leading poet and a famous dramatist, produced 154 sonnets. Daniel Drayton, Gravelle and Constable are some other sonneters of this age. This age is also known as Elizabethan age, and this age is particularly famous for the development of drama and poetry. Edmund Spenser, a remarkable poet of this age, produced The Fairy Queen, an outstanding epic. Spenser is called the poet's poet because of his excellent poetic qualities. The 17th century is also a leading century regarding developing of English poetry. In the beginning of this century, John Donne, known as metaphysical poet, contributed wonderfully to the development of English poetry. John Donne is regarded as the greatest poet of metaphysical school of poetry. In the beginning of this century, Milton was recognized as the greatest poet because he composed highly outstanding epic The Paradise Lost and many other famous poems. During this period, some other metaphysical poets like George Herbert, Richard Crossan, Henry Bogham, Thomas Crewe, Abraham Cowley and Andrew Marvell also produced metaphysical poems. Some poets known as Cavalier poet like Robert Herrick, Richard Lovelace and Sir John Suckling, chiefly with Love and Bar. After the last half of this age was John Dryden, whose satiric power and craftsmanship influenced the vast area of English poetry. As a poet, Dryden cannot be placed in the highest rank along with Shakespeare and Milton, but he deserves an eminent place in the second order of poet. The poetry of the 18th century, which is also known as Augustan age, is the product of intelligence, good sense and reasonableness. It was strictly confined to town, so it was also known as drawing room. Poetry, the poets of this period cared for form and took all pain to polish and refine the poetic style. During this period, the satiric and narrative forms of poetry flourished. Heroic couplet dominated English poetry. The most remarkable poet of this age was Alexander Pope, who acknowledged Dryden as his poetic master and who was influenced by Boileau, the French poet. The publication of Essay on Criticism and the Rape of the Lock stormed him into popularity. Matthew Prior, John Gay, Edward Young, Samuel Garth, William Somerville and Lady Winchelsea are some other leading poets of this period. In the second half of this century, there came a new kind of English poetry known as transitional poetry, which paved the way for the romantic poet of the 19th century. James Thomson, Oliver Goldsmith, Thomas Gray, William Collin, William Cowper, George Grave, Mark Akenside, Christopher Smart, William Spenston, Chatterton and Macpherson are some of transitional poets of this period. William Blake, Burns and Goldsmith laid emphasis on the nature poetry. The beginning of the 19th century, known as the Romantic Age, is the most distinguished period in the development of English poetry. Mystery, interest in past, love of nature, interest in humanity, love for simple and natural life, emphasis on sentiments, emotion and imagination bear the chief features of the romantic poetry. These romantic poets were deeply influenced by French Revolution. The chief romantic poets are William Wordsworth, S.T. Coleridge, P.V. Shelley and John Keats. Love of nature was common to all the romantic poets. They were all lyrical poets. They were deeply influenced by Hellenism and medievalism. After the Romantic Age, the last half of the 19th century is known as the Victorian Age. Victorian Age is an age of prosperity and progress. New education, social unrest, social purpose and realism, advance of democratic ideals, the progress of sincere and new norms for the society. Tennyson, Browning and Matthew Arnold are the most leading poet of this age. During this period, a new kind of poetry known as pre-Raphaelite poetry was written. These poets laid emphasis on the extension of romantic revival mannerism, art for art's sake, picture quickness, love of symbolism and music and melody. G.D.G. Rossetti, William Morris, A.C. Swinburne are the pre-Raphaelites. In the first half of the 20th century, there was a change in English poetic outlook. The romantic tradition of the previous age was rejected. Now the poet was no longer a singer of dreams, expressing himself in sweet words. The poet had to express the scenario of life and society around him. T.S. Eliot was both a demonstration and the manifesto of what the new invented to do and could do. With the adventure of the 20th century, existing poetic tradition did not change significantly. There was the note of full of promise and greatness in the opening year of 20th century. With the change in subject matter, the change in poetic technique. The new experiences needed a new style and speech for expression. The first 20 years of 20th century may be treated as transitional period. Alfred Austin, W.E. Henley, John Davidson, Watson, Francis Thompson, Rudyard Kipling, Thomas Hardy, Robert Bridges and A.E. Hansman are chief traditional poet of this period. The World War also affected the poets, so some of them wrote on the theme of war. Rupert Brooke, Wilfred Quinn, Siegfried Sassoon and Sorley are known as war poets. W.B. Yeats, whose poetry characteristics mysticism, romanticism and symbolism occupies a distinct place east, may not be a Shakespeare or a Milton, but he must certainly be compared with the greatest poet of all times. There were certain poets who are known as Georgian poet, and they include Wells, D. La Mare, John Masefield, J. E. Flecker, Edward Thomas Gibson, John Drinkwater, G.K. Chesterton, Abercrombie, but G.M. Hopkins, T.S. Eliot and Sitwell revolted against these Georgian poets. Among these modern poets, T.S. Eliot is the most outstanding, who started his own trends. The poet Stephen Spencer, Cecil Day Lewis are known as Oxford poets. During this age, there also started a new trend, neo-romanticism, and the poets who are connected with this movement are Dylan, Thomas, and Baker. Thus, this century could not impress like the 18th or 19th century. Thanks, best of luck.